plus constant minus half into coefficient of x whole square. Applying this formula, then the given quadratic equation will reduce us to some important integrals. By equating the coefficient of x and constant, you will get the value of L and M. Substitute and integrate it, you will get the answer. That's it. If the function is in the denominator and differentiation in the numerator, then this can be written as log of f of x plus c. Hello dear students, welcome to this session of mathematics class. I am Mr. Niranjan, faculty of mathematics, Vidyashram PU College, the temple of excellence. In my previous class, we have discussed regarding some important integrals, how to evaluate some important integrals and the formulas for some important integrals. Now, based on those formulas, now we are going to use those concepts to evaluate other type of integrals. Now, any integral of the form, a linear equation divided by a quadratic equation. Now, let us come to the first problem, first method. Now, integrals of the form 1 over ax square plus bx plus c, that is dx divided by a quadratic equation, dx divided by a quadratic equation. Now, convert this quadratic equation into some important integrals. Reduce this equation into some important integrals, then evaluate it. That's it. Now, how to solve this problem? There is a general method to solve this problem. Ax square plus bx plus c, any quadratic equation, this ax square plus bx plus c, just take a out, coefficient of x square is a. Now, divide by a, that is x square plus b by a into x plus c. Now, the very important formula we are going to use for this is a into x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant minus half into coefficient of x whole the square. This is very, very important formula. So a into x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant minus half into coefficient of x whole square. Applying this formula, then the given quadratic equation will reduce us to some important integrals. So, completing the square method. Now, x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant minus half into coefficient of x whole square. Then evaluate using some important integrals. That's it. Now, let us come to the first problem. To find the integral of dx divided by x square minus 6x plus 13. So, this is a quadratic equation. Simplify this. First, now this x square minus 6x plus 13 can be written as x plus, what is the formula? X plus half into coefficient of x is minus 6 whole square plus constant. Constant is 13 minus half into, again coefficient of x is minus 6 whole the square. Now this can be written as x, 3 2s are gets cancelled, x minus 3 whole square plus 13 minus 2 3s are gets cancelled, minus 3 square. So this can be written as x minus 3 whole square plus 13 minus 3 square is 9. This is equal to x minus 3 whole square, 13 minus 9 is equal to 4 plus 4. This can also put it in the form of 2 square plus x minus 3 whole the square. Okay, see here. Just x square minus 6x plus 13 can be written as x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant minus half into coefficient of x whole square. Here the coefficient of x is minus 6, constant is 13. X plus 1 by 2 into minus 6 whole square plus 13 minus half into again coefficient of x whole square. 2 3s are gets cancelled, x minus 6 plus 13 as it is. Again 2 3s are gets cancelled, minus 3 square. Minus 3 square is 9, 13 minus 9 is 4. So, this can also be written as 4 can be written as 2 square. The given integral becomes, I'll go to the next page, the given integral. Therefore, the given integral 1 over x square minus 6x plus 13, x square minus 6x plus 13 dx reduces to 1 over 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square into dx. See, 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square into dx. Right. Now, this is of the form, if you observe carefully, this is of the form integral 1 over a square plus x square dx. integration of 1 over a square plus x square dx is 1 over a into tan inverse of x by a plus c. That's it. This is very simple problem. So substitute here 1 over a. What is a to 1 over a? 1 over 2 tan inverse of x minus 3 by 2 plus c is the integrated answer. Now just first reduce to this form and use any formula related to some important integrals. That's it. Now first the intention is to convert into this form, any form. Okay, see here, integral 1 over x square minus 6x plus 13 reduces to 1 over x square plus x minus 3 whole square. This is of the form 1 over a square plus x square dx is 1 over a tan inverse x by a, 1 over 2 into tan inverse x minus 3 by 2 plus c. So if you simplify this, definitely you will get this much. Okay, this is how we are going to solve this problem. Now let us come to the second problem. Suppose to find the integral of the form dx divided by 3x square plus 13x minus 10. Again, this is a quadratic equation. Now, let us convert this quadratic equation. Now, this can be written as 3x square plus 13x minus 10. Here, you can remove the constant 3 out, x square divided by 3, 13 by 3 into x minus 10 by 3. Now, if you apply the formula for this, what is the formula? This 3 out, x plus half into coefficient of x is 13 by 3 whole square, x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant is minus 10 by 3, x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant, again minus half into coefficient of x is 13 by 3 whole the square. This is the formula. Okay, see here I will write the formula, x plus half into coefficient of x whole square, x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant minus half into coefficient of x whole the square. This is the formula we are making use. X plus half into coefficient of x is 13 by 3 whole square plus constant minus 10 by 3 minus half into coefficient of x is 13 by 3 whole the square. Now this is equal to, see here, this is equal to 3 into x plus, multiply this, 13 into 1 is 13 divided by 2, 3 is a 6 whole square, x plus 13 by 6 whole square, okay, minus 10 by 3 as it is, again minus, this can be written as 13 into 1 is 13 divided by 3, 2 is a 6 whole the square. Now simplify this, okay, the first step is, so 3 into x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 10 by 3 minus 13 by 13 divided by 6 whole the square. This can be written as 3 into, now x plus 13 by 6 whole square as it is minus, again this is 10 by 3 also same. Now simplify this, 13 square, 13 into 13, 169 divided by 6 square is 36. Now simplify these two. Now I will go to the next page, that is 3 into x plus 13 by 6, x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 10 by 3 minus 169 by 36. Now let us simplify this. This is 3 into, this is same, x plus 13 by 6 whole square is same. Now take LCM here. Here LCM is 36 is the LCM. 36 is the LCM. Now, so 36, you divide 36 by 3, it will cancel by 12 times. 12 into 10 is 120, this is 120 minus, 120 minus, 36 gets cancelled, 169. So this is equal to 3 into x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus, minus 120 minus 169 is minus 289 divided by 36. Now this can be written as 3 into x plus 13 by 6 whole square, and what is this 289 divided by 36? 289 divided by 16 is nothing but 17 divided by 6 whole the square. That's it. So 3 into x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 17 by 6 whole square is the simplified answer. Now integrate it, that's it. Now, therefore, this given integral becomes, now the given integral becomes, given integral 1 over, what is the problem? 3x square plus 13x minus 10 dx reduces to 1 over 3 out, 1 over this x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 17 by 6 whole square into dx. That's it. Now integrate this. If you observe carefully, this is of the form integral 1 over x square minus a square dx. 1 over x square minus a square dx is 1 over 2a log of mod x minus a by x plus a plus c. What is the integral of 1 over x square minus a square? 1 over 2a log x minus a by x plus a plus c is the integrated answer for this. Now apply the formula and simplify. That's it. Okay. Now let us simplify this. Now this is 1 over 3 as it is. 1 over 2 times what is a? A is equal to 17 by 6 into logarithm of mod of x. X is x plus 13 by 6 minus a. 17 by 6 whole divided by x again. X plus 13 by 6 plus a 17 by 6 plus c. Now cancel the terms which gets cancelled. 3 2s are 6 gets cancelled. 1 over 17 times logarithm of, take LCM, 6 is the LCM, this is 6x, 6x gets cancelled, 13 minus 7 whole divided by, again 6 is the LCM, 6x plus 13 plus 7 plus c, 6 and 6 gets cancelled. What is left over is 1 over 17 into logarithm of modulus of 6x. Yes, 13 minus 7. 13 minus 7 is equal to 13 minus 17. Sorry, it is not 7. This is 17. 13 minus 17. So, 13 minus 17 is equal to minus 4 divided by 6x plus 13 plus 17 is equal to 30 plus c. If you want, you can take common factor, divide by 2. So, this reduces to, the final answer we are going to get is, the final answer is 1 over 17 into logarithm of, if you take 2 common factor and divide, you will get, this is 3x minus 2 divided by 3x plus 15 plus c is the integrated answer. So, the integrated answer is 1 over 17 times logarithm of 3x minus 2 divided by 3x plus 15 plus c is the integrated answer. So, if you do this much, you will get 5 marks. These are all 5 mark questions. Okay, followed? That's it. Okay, now let us come to the next type of problem. Now, integrals type 2. What is the type 2? Second type integrals. Integrals of the form dx divided by root of ax square plus bx plus c. That is 1 over a square root of a quadratic equation. Previous one is a quadratic equation. Now it is a square root of a quadratic equation. So for this, the method is same. Let us take the previous problem itself. What is, just integrate? Integrate 1 over x square minus 6x plus 13 under root. Now let us convert this x square minus 6x plus 13. Now using previous method, this is converted into, so this is equal to, what is the answer we got from the previous problem? So, x 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square. 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square. This is from first, from problem number 1, page number 1. So, from previous problem, we did the same problem. X square minus 6x plus 13 can be written as 2 square plus x minus 3. So, this given integral becomes, this reduces to integral 1 over square root of 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square into dx. Now, if you observe carefully, this is integral of the form 1 over a square plus x square dx. 1 over a square plus dx. What is the formula for integral of 1 over a square plus x square dx? Now, the formula for this is logarithm of x plus root of a square plus x square or x square plus a square plus c under mod. So, therefore, this can be written as logarithm of modulus of x is nothing but x minus 3 plus root of a square plus x square is nothing but the given equation itself. 2 square is 4 plus x minus 3 whole square mod plus c. This is the required answer. So the required answer for this is logarithm of x minus 3 plus square root of 4 plus x minus 3 whole square plus c is the integrated answer. This is c. Okay. That's it. Integral 1 over square root of x square minus 6x plus 13. So x square minus 6x plus 13 from the previous problem, problem number 1, we can put it in the form of 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square. 1 over square root of 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square is of the form. Integral 1 over root of a square plus x square is log of x plus root of a square plus x square under mod. So log integral of 1 over square root of 2 square plus x minus 3 whole square is logarithm of mod. X is nothing but x minus 3 plus square root of a square plus x square. A square is 4 plus x square is x minus 3 whole square plus c is the integrated answer. Hope you followed this. That's it. Okay. Now let us take one more problem. Now to find the integrals of the form, let us come to this problem. 5x square minus 2x. Now this 5x square minus 2x can be written as, you can take 5 out, x square minus 2 by 5 times x. Apply the formula. This is x plus half into coefficient of x is 2 by 5 whole square. X plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant. Constant is 0. Again minus half into coefficient of x is minus 2 by 5 whole the square. This is 5 times x. 2 and 2 gets cancelled, minus 1 by 5 whole square plus 0. Again 2 and 2 gets cancelled. 2 and 2 gets cancelled. You will get minus 1 by 5 whole the square. So this is equal to 5 times x minus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 by 5 whole square is nothing but 1 by 25. So the simplified answer for the 5x square minus 2x is 5 times x minus 5 whole square minus 1 by 25. Or if you want, you can also put it in the form of 5 into x minus 1 over 5 whole square minus 1 by 25 can also be written as 1 over 5 the square, 1 by 5 whole square. Okay, see here, 5x square minus 2x, you can take 5 constant out, a out, 5 out, x square minus 2 by 5x. Now what is the coefficient of x is minus 2 by 5, apply the formula. X plus half into coefficient of x is minus 2 by 5 whole square plus constant is 0 minus half into again coefficient of x is minus 2 by 5 whole square. So 2 2 gets cancelled, x minus 1 by 5 whole square plus 0 minus 2 2 gets cancelled, minus 1 by 5 whole square. X minus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 5 into 1 by 5, that is 1 by 25, that can also be written as plus 1 by 5 whole square. Now I will go to the next page. Now, therefore, the given equation reduces to, therefore, the given integral, integral 1 over square root of 5x square minus 2x reduces to integral 1 over square root of, what is this equal to, 5 times x minus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 by 5 whole the square. This is the reduced form. Now, this is equal to, you can take 1 over root 5 out, integral 1 over square root of x minus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 over 5 whole square into dx. Now, if you observe carefully, this integral of the form, this is of the form, integral 1 over root of x square minus a square dx. Integral 1 over root of x square minus a square dx. What is the integral? Now, listen. Integral 1 over root of x square minus a square dx is nothing but log of x plus root of x square minus a square mod plus c. This is the integrated answer. If you want, you can write integral of 1 over x square minus a square is nothing but logarithm of mod x plus root of x square minus a square plus c. Okay, this is the formula for this integral 1 over x square minus a square dx. Substitute it and simplify. That's it, you will get the answer. Now, therefore, this reduces to logarithm of logarithm of modulus of x. What is x? X is nothing but x minus 1 over 5 plus square root of x square minus a square is nothing but x minus 1 over 5 whole square minus a square. A square is nothing but 1 by 5 whole the square mod plus c. This is the required answer. That's it. What is the required answer? Logarithm of x. X is nothing but x minus 1 over 5 plus root of x minus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 by 5 whole square plus c is the simplified answer. That's it. Once if we simplify and reduce to some important integrals, straight away you can substitute the formula. See, integral of 1 over x square minus a square dx is log of mod x plus root of x square minus a square. So, the integral of this along with 1 by root 5 constant. 1 over root 5 into mod x minus 1 by 5 plus square root of x minus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 by 5 whole square plus c is the integrated answer. That's it. Hope you followed. Very important questions for 5 or 6 marks. Very important. Hope followed. Now, let us come to the next method. Next method is a linear equation divided by a quadratic equation. So, integrals type 3 integrals of the form px plus q divided by ax square plus bx plus c. A linear equation divided by a quadratic equation. This is also very important. For this, what is the method we are going to use? Px plus q divided by ax square plus bx plus c integrate dx can also be written as let the numerator, this is very important formula, let the numerator is equal to L into d by dx of denominator plus m. What is the numerator? Px plus q is equal to L into differentiation of denominator, a constant, x square is 2x plus bx is b plus c constant 0 plus m. Now, px plus q is equal to L into 2ax plus b plus m, where L and m are constant. By equating the coefficient of x and constant, you will get the value of L and m, substitute and integrate it. We'll get the answer. That's it. Very simple problem. See here, integral of the form px plus q divided by ax square plus bx plus c. Now, let the numerator L is equal to L into d by dx of denominator plus m. Now, what is numerator? Px plus q is equal to L into differentiation of denominator ax square is 2ax plus bx is b plus c constant 0 plus m. Equating the coefficient of x and constant, you will get the value of L and M, substitute and integrate it. That will give the answer. That's it. Very simple. Now, but the steps are more. This is 6 mark or 5 mark question. Now, let us take one example. Evaluate to find the integral x plus 2 divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 5. Now, let the numerator, what is the formula? Let the numerator is equal to L into d by dx of denominator plus m. That is, numerator x plus 2 is equal to L into d by dx of what is the denominator 2x plus 6x plus 5 plus m. Okay, that is x plus 2 is equal to L into differentiation of 2x square is 4x plus differentiation of 6x is 6 plus m. Right. Now, equating the coefficient of x and constant. Now, equating coefficient of x and constants. Let us equate the coefficient of x and constant. What is the coefficient of x is 1. On the left hand side it is 1. Right hand side 4 into L is 4L. Therefore, L is equal to 1 by 4. So, you will get one value. L is equal to 1 by 4. Right. Now, constant. What is the constant? 2. 2 is equal to constant terms. 2 is equal to here 6 into L is 6L. Plus m is the constant. Now, transfer this. What is required to find is m. So, m is equal to 2 minus 6L. 2 minus 6 into L is 1 by 4. This can be written as m is equal to, take LCM, 4 is the LCM. 2 4s are 8 minus 6. 8 minus 6 is 2 by 4. 2 by 4 is nothing but 1 by 2. So, m is equal to 1 by 2. That's it. So, these are the values of L and M. Substitute here. this equation becomes, therefore, x plus 2 is equal to L. What is L? L is equal to 1 by 4 into 4x plus 6 plus M. What is M? M is equal to 1 by 2. That's it. Now, integrate it, you will get the answer. That's it. Very simple. See here. Let the numerator is equal to L into d by dx of denominator 2x plus 6x plus 5 plus M. Differentiation of x square is 2x, 2 into 2 is 4x plus 6x is 6 plus M. Equating the coefficient of x and constant. The coefficient of x is 1 is equal to 4L. Therefore, L is equal to 1 by 4. Constant terms. The coefficient of constant term. Constant terms 2 is equal to 4 is 6 into L plus M. 6 into L plus M. Therefore, M is equal to 2 minus 6L. 6 into L is 1 by 4. Take LCM, you will get M is equal to 1 by 2. This is 1 by 2, positive value. So, L is equal to 1 by 4 and M is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, this equation reduces to x plus 2 is equal to 1 by 4 into 4x plus 6 plus M is equal to 1 by 2. Substitute this value. What is x plus 2? Substitute this and divide term by term. Evaluate, you will get the answer. That's it. Now, okay, I'll go to the next page. Now, the given integral, integral x plus 2 divided by, what is it? 2x square plus 6x plus 5, 2x square plus 6x plus 5 dx can be written as, what is the numerator? X plus 2 is 1 by 4 into 4x plus 6 plus 1 by 2. 1 by 4 into 4x plus 6 plus 1 by 2 whole divided by denominator 2x square plus 6x plus 5 dx. Now, term by term divide it. This is equal to 1 over 4 into integral 4x plus 6 divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 5 into dx plus second part 1 by 2 out 1 over 2x square plus 6x plus 5 into dx. This is term by term integral. See here, numerator 1 by 4 into 4x plus 6 plus 1 by 2. Split it. 1 over 4 into 4x plus 6 divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus second term 1 by 2 into the denominator 2x square plus 6x plus 5. Now let us call it as I1 and I2. Integrate separately. What is I1? This is I1 and that is I2. Now take I1. I1 is equal to 1 over 4 into 4x plus 6 divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 5 into dx. If you observe carefully, this is how the form. This is how the form. Integral f dash of x divided by f of x dx. If the function is in the denominator and differentiation in the numerator, then this can be written as log of f of x plus c. See here, what is the derivative of 2x square? 4x. Derivative of 6x is 6, 5 constant 0. F dash x by f of x. Therefore, this is equal to 1 over 4 into log of f of x, log of 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus c1. This is the first integral. I1 is equal to 1 over 4 into log of 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus c1. Followed. Listen to me again. The first part, I1 is equal to 1 over 4 into 4x plus 6 divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 5 dx. This is how the form integral f dash x by f of x dx is log f of x. 1 over 4 into log of f of x is 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus c. Integral f dash x by f of x is nothing but logarithm of f of x plus c. Logarithm of f of x is 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus c1. This is first one. Come to the second part, I2. What is I2? I2 is again a quadratic equation. Now, I2. 1 over 2 into 1 by 2x square plus 6x plus 5. 1 over 2x square plus 6x plus 5 into dx. Now, simplify this. Now, 2x square plus 6x plus 5. Again, this is 1 over a quadratic equation. Convert this. You can take 2 out. X square plus 6 by 2 is 3x plus 5 by 2. This is 2 into x plus half into coefficient of x is 3 whole square plus constant 5 by 2 minus half into coefficient of x is 3 all the square. This can be written as 2 into x plus This is 3/2. 3/2 whole square plus 5/2 minus 3/2 whole the square. Simplify this. 2 into x plus 3/2 whole square plus 5/2 minus 9/4. Now this can be written as 2 times x plus 3/2 as it is. Now take LCM. Plus what is the LCM? 4 is the LCM. 2 2s are gets cancelled, 2 5s are 10 minus 4 and 4 gets cancelled, 9. So this can be written as 2 into x plus 3/2 whole square plus 1/4. This is 2 into x plus 3/2 whole the square plus 1/4 can be written as 1/2 whole square. Okay, I'll substitute here. Therefore, the given integral I2 becomes I2 is equal to 1 over 2 into integral. What is this? Integral 1 over 2 times x plus 3/2 whole square plus 1/2 whole square into dx. This can be written as 1/2 into 1/2 is 1/4. If you observe carefully, this is of the form integral 1 over a square plus x square. 1 over a square 1/2 whole square plus x plus 3/2 whole square into dx. 1 over a square plus x square dx is 1 over a tan inverse of x by a. I'll write the formula integral 1 over a square plus x square dx. Integration of 1 over a square plus x square dx is 1 over a tan inverse x by a. Plus c. Right. 1 over a tan inverse x by a plus c. Now, let us substitute this. This is equal to, I'll write here, 1 over 4 as it is, 1 over a. 1 over a is 1/2 tan inverse of x. X plus 3/2 divided by 1/2 plus c. Now, here what happens, this 2 goes to the numerator, this will get cancelled, 1/2. So, the answer we are going to get is 1/2 tan inverse of, I will rub it and do it. Listen. So, this is the second part. I2 is equal to integral 1 over 2x square plus 6x plus 15. Applying the formula, you are going to get it as 2 times x plus 3 whole square plus 1/2 whole square. So, integrate it. Now, let me rub this. I will rub this and I will do again. See, this is 1 over 4. So, this 2 and 2 gets cancelled. 1 over 2 into tan inverse of, take LCM. 2 is the LCM. 2 into x is 2x. Plus 3 divided by 1/2 plus c. This 2 and 2 gets cancelled. 1 over 2 tan inverse 2x plus 3 divided by 2 into 2/1 plus c. This 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Therefore, I2 is equal to 1 over 2 times tan inverse of 2x plus 3 plus c2. Now, therefore, the required integral I is equal to I1 plus I2. What is I1? From the previous page, what is I1? I1 is equal to 1 over 4 log of, this is I is equal to 1 over 4 log of the denominator 2x square plus 6x plus 5, 2x square plus 6x plus 5, again plus I2. What is I2? Plus I2 1 over 2 into tan inverse of 2x plus 3 plus capital C, where C is equal to C1 plus C2. This is the required answer, the lengthiest answer. The given integral is 1 over 4 log of 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus 1/2 tan inverse 2x plus 3 plus C is the integrated answer. 6 marker, very important and very easy, but steps are more. That's it. Okay, followed? Hope you followed this. Now, let us come to the last method. Integrals of the form a linear equation divided by a square root of a quadratic equation. Px plus q divided by square root of ax square plus bx plus c. In this case also, the procedure is same as that of the previous problem. Now, let us take an example. Example, evaluate or find the integral of x plus 3 dx divided by square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square. Now, let the numerator is equal to l into d by dx of denominator plus m. What is the numerator here? X plus 3 is equal to L into d by dx of denominator is 5 minus 4x minus x square plus m. Simplify this. X plus 3 is equal to L into differentiation of I constant, 4 into differentiation of x is 1 minus x square is 2x plus m. Now equating the coefficient of x and constant. So coefficient of x and constants. What happens? The coefficient of x. Let us come to the coefficient of x. Therefore, the coefficient of x 1 is equal to minus 2L. Therefore, L is equal to minus 1 by 2. First answer. Constant term. The coefficient of constant term. What are the constant term? 3 is equal to minus 4L. 3 is equal to minus 4L plus M. Okay. Now transfer this. 3 plus 4L is equal to M. M is equal to 3 plus 4 into what is L? Minus 1 by 2. So M is equal to 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. M is equal to 1. Therefore, this equation becomes the numerator. X plus 3 is equal to, this reduces to L. L is, what is L? Minus 1 by 2 into minus 4 minus 2x plus M. Now, therefore, I'll go to the next page. Therefore, the numerator x plus 3 is equal to L into d by dx of denominator minus 4 minus 2x plus M. X plus 3 is equal, what is L? L is equal to minus 1 by 2 into minus 4 minus 2x plus M is 1. Now, therefore, the given integral becomes, the given integral is equal to integral. What is the given integral? X plus 3 dx divided by square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square. 5 minus 4x minus x square can be written as, in the numerator, you can put 1 by 2 into minus 4 minus 2x plus 1 dx divided by, the denominator is 5 minus 4x minus x square along with integral sign. Now, term by term division. If you divide, this is minus 1 by 2 into minus 4 minus 2x divided by square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square dx again plus 1 divided by square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square dx. Now let us call it as I1 and I2. I is equal to I1 and I2. What is I1? Minus 1 by 2 minus 4 minus 2x divided by 5 minus 4x minus x square. Now let us take the first integral I1. Now I will come to the first integral I1. What is I1? Minus 1 by 2 into integral of minus 4 minus 2x divided by square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square into dx. Now let us take the substitution. Put t is equal to inside root. Now what you will get? Dt is equal to differentiation of 5 constant minus 4x is minus 4 and differentiation of x square is minus 2x into dx. Now I1 is equal to minus 1 by 2 into minus 4 minus 2x divided by square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square dx. Now let us take the substitution as this. T is equal to 5 minus 4x minus x square. Dt is equal to minus 4 minus 2x dx. Therefore, this integral I1 is equal to minus 1 by 2 times dt divided by root t. Minus 1 over 2 times t to the power of minus of dt. Integrate this. This is minus 1 over t into integral of minus half plus 1 is half by half plus c 1. This 2 gets cancelled. This is nothing but minus root t plus c 1. So substitute the value of t. What is t? T is equal to 5 minus 4x minus x square plus c 1. Therefore, this given integral becomes I1. What is I1? Minus I1 is equal to minus of square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square plus c. Followed. Okay, now let us come to I2. What is I2? Now I2. I2 is equal to integral. What is I2? 1 over 5 minus 4x minus x square. 1 over square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square dx. Now simplify this. Now 5 minus 4x minus x square can be written as, put it in the form, minus 5x square minus 4x plus 5. You can take minus sign out, x square plus 4x minus 5. Now simplify, x plus half into coefficient of x is 4 whole the square plus constant is minus 5, again minus half into coefficient of x is 4 whole the square. This is equal to minus half, x plus 2 2s gets cancelled, x plus 2 whole square minus 5, again 2 2s gets cancelled, 2 square is 4. This can be written as minus of x plus 2 whole square minus 9. Multiply by negative sign, you will get minus of x plus 2 whole square minus into minus plus. This can also be written as, I can put in the form of, first take 9, 9 can be written as 3 square minus x plus 2 whole the square. 3 square minus x plus 2 whole the square. So therefore this integral becomes integral 1 over square root of 3 square minus x plus 2 whole square into dx. This is I2. Now evaluate using some important integrals. That's it. Now this is of the form integral 1 over root of a square minus x square dx. 1 over root of a square minus x square dx is nothing but sine inverse of x by a plus c. This can be written as sine inverse of x plus 2 divided by 3 plus c2. This is I2. Okay. Now, therefore, the given integral, therefore, I is equal to I1 plus I2. What is I1? I1 is minus square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square plus c1 minus square root of 5 minus 4x minus x square plus I2. I2 is sine inverse of x plus 2 divided by 3 plus c, where c is equal to c1 plus c. This is the required answer. The given answer, the required answer is minus root of 5 minus 4x minus x square plus sine inverse of x plus 2 divided by 3 plus c is the integrated answer. This is how we are going to evaluate all the four times. First one is dx divided by a quadratic equation. Second one is dx divided by square root of a quadratic equation. In these two methods, convert the quadratic equation using the formula. Again, third, a linear equation, px plus q divided by a quadratic equation. And the fourth one is px plus q divided by square root of ax square plus bx plus c into dx. All these methods. So, convert this into some important integrals and evaluate it. The very important formula we are going to use here is x plus half into coefficient of x whole square plus constant minus half into coefficient of x whole square. Okay. Hope you followed this practice. These are very lengthiest problem, but easy, very lengthy. Don't get confused with this problem. Now, that's all for the day. Let us meet with a different concept in the next session. Thank you. Thank you very much.